Hello everyone. Today let us see how we are going to add devices into the Zabbix by auto discovery. As you can see, there are 8 devices and I have just added 3 devices in AWS called as line 1, line 2, line 3. It's just our naming convention. But their IP addresses are like these. So I'm going to write a discovery rule and an action to add them automatically. So what we have to do is we have to go to discovery, and then here we have to write discovery rule, create discovery rule, and just push a little towards the right, and then AWS devices, and then as there is no proxy, not mentioning anything, I'm going to put a couple of devices off from the range 3.137.185.195.2.201. So you can see one of the devices is in this range. So we can just add a couple of other devices in the same range so that I want to make sure that this device gets discovered too. The other advantage of the Zabbix is that we can mention more IP ranges by putting a comma, but if they are in a different subnet, it is better to create different rules. So for the advantage, let me make it 1 minute. And then let me do a check here, which is a mandatory field. So Zabbix is giving so many options to validate whether the any of these or many of these checks satisfy, only then it gets discovered. So for the sake of simplicity, I'm going to ping that the device should be pingable. Yep, rule is added. And then the uniqueness will be from the IP address. The host name will be the DNS name. The visible name will be the host name. Finally, we have this check mark, right? And I am gonna add, and let me create another rule for another device. My devices. Okay, and there is no proxy here. I'm gonna add for the second 73.16.81. And I am partially set. So I have 2 rules created, that is AWS devices and my devices. So we are in the discovery rules under the configuration tab. So is that all? No, we have to do one more step, which is actions under configuration. In that we have a lot of drop downs here, 4 basically. And then we have to select discovery action. In the discovery actions, I need to create an action. What I need to do when I discover something. So basically, here we can see in the monitoring discovery, we can see these devices have been added. So as you can see, 3.137.185.199 is my IP, and it is discovered 198.199. 200, so had given a couple of servers range, so it has discovered them. So likewise, the next minute, the other range will also be discovered. So now, it is discovered from the AWS devices group, and now it has discovered another device from the My Devices group. So is that the device which is in My AWS? Yes, it is 3.16.81.222. That's good. my devices are discovered. But are these added to my devices? No. So how that is done is I have to go to configuration, click on actions. So in the actions, I had to create an action and tell that my discovered devices AWS. I'm just giving a name. So in the conditions, you can just click on add, and here we get an option like either the host IP or the discovery check, discovery object, discovery rule, discovery status, proxy, received value, all those things. So for me, the straightforward better option is the discovery rule. I will select both of them because I want to see all the devices getting added. Okay, and I click on select, and then click on add. Okay, so this has got added, but is it on? No, we are left with some more part in this. Here we go to operations tab, click on add. So now it says that whatever you have found the devices from those two rules, what has to be done? By default, is send message. No, I want, you know, I have multiple options like remote command, execute a remote command, add host, remove host, add to host group, remove from host group, link to template, unlink, and all those things. I prefer add to host group because this will add the host as well as move it to the host group. So I will say AWS, and I have a group created called my AWS host group. In addition to that, is there anything that I need to do? And click on add again. From the drop down, I say link to templates. So in one action itself, I can configure multiple sub actions to be created or action. So the meaning of this action is that the discovery rule finds out the devices in the IP range which are up and running. And the action part will execute and add those discovered devices which we found earlier into the my AWS group and also deploy the template SMB ping. So let me just add them. Okay, so let me just go to discovery, and then for the sake of simplicity, I'll just say disable and so let's go to monitoring and discovery. Here we can see these devices have been discovered. Now the rule runs for action. Here we will see whether they have been added to monitoring or not. As of now, the monitored host tab is empty. So let's wait for a few more moments till the rule runs and these devices gets added. So if we go to the host tab, we can still see the number of hosts as 8. So as and when these gets discovered and added by the action, it will be added over here. Let's go back to discovery and let's wait for it. Let's click on disable. Let's go back to discovery and validate whether it just vanished. Yes, it just vanished. Let's go back to discovery and then enable them. So what happens is that whenever we are running a discovery and when we disable them, the discovered devices just vanishes from this list here, but when they get added, it's a permanent one. So we have to understand that there are two things. So as and when we disable the discovery rule, the servers discovered or the devices discovered here vanishes from this list, but once they get added into the monitor host, it's a permanent addition. So the time this device gets added. See, as we can see, the three devices got added into Zabbix, and we can just wait for a few more moments for the fourth device to get added. Yep, the fourth device is also added. Now let's go back to host in the monitoring tab. We will see 8 plus 4, 12. Yes. Right, as we can see here, these four devices have been added into the Zabbix with ICMP method, and the templates have been deployed onto it, which is ICMP ping. So if you go to hosts here, and we can validate them. Yep, as I can see, these devices which are newly added have got the template ICMP ping, ICMP ping, ICMP ping, ICMP ping. That's good. So this is how we can get the devices added into Zabbix automatically by discovery. But very essential part in the discovery is that if at all we define a rule which is going to discover a lot of devices, then it can create havoc by adding so many unwanted devices. For example, there could be laptops and desktops which could be coming and going out of the network, and if our IP range is badly configured, or if the discovery interval is configured to be very low, like 1 minute. 1 minute is too low. Actually, for the sake of testing, I've given it as 1 minute, but ideally it should be nothing less than 1 day or a week, weekly once, let it auto discover. Or when we are writing the rule, we can say that only if the device uptime is more than 48 hours or something like that, only then add it, because no other devices which are going in and out of the network, like the laptops, would have the uptime more than 48 hours or a week, for example. So only those devices which are permanently there in the network should be added. So we can write rules like that. So as I said, discovery is a very powerful process which can add many devices automatically, and by the rules, however we want to configure it, customize it, it definitely helps us to simplify the process of host additions, be it network devices or servers. But at the same time, if we define one wrong rule, then it can play havoc. More videos in the next. Watch out.